Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14 Beta 3 has been out for well over a week and a half. I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max as my main device. I've also been using it on my 2020 iPad Pro 12.9. Those are my two main devices running iOS 14 and iPadOS 14. I've also got it on my iPhone XR, my first generation iPhone SE, and then here I have iOS 13.6 running on my iPhone 11. So I wanted to talk about how iOS 13.6 has been, whether or not we'll see another version, bugs that still exist, things like that. And then we'll talk about iOS 14. And all of this information is not only based on my experience, but your experience as well, based on well over 15,000 or so votes on the YouTube community poll. So since I posted those, there has been a ton of votes. Now, first, I wanted to share with you a new thing you can do with badges. You may have seen this already. 9 to 5 Mac posted a story on it, but you can make a Memoji badge if you want to do that. And so I'm going to share with you a shortcut. I'll paste it in the description if you want to try it out from 9 to 5 Mac. And also, let me show you how to do this. It's really simple. Now, you want to open up Notes, and within Notes, tap on your emoji keyboard. Now, this works on iOS 13 and 14 as long as you have that shortcut installed. Then go ahead and pick your Memoji. Now, you'll have to create one of these using Messages, and then you'll have your Memoji stickers. So I'll pick this one, and then we'll tap here. What we'll do is we'll press and hold on our Memoji. So meaning we'll press and hold using haptic touch or 3D touch, then we'll go to share. If you scroll down in your share sheet, I have it at the bottom, to run a shortcut, Apple Store Memoji Badge. Tap on that. It will open up, and it will allow you to select your first name. So I'll type Aaron in this case, but you can type whatever you'd like. We'll hit done. Then it's going to ask me, what color Apple logo would I like? I'll just tap on random. It takes a moment to create it. And then what we'll do is, when it pops up here, we'll save it to our photos. Now, I will warn you, it is a little bit buggy. So if I have Do Not Disturb turned on, it doesn't normally run the shortcut properly in iOS 14. But now it's saved, and let's take a look at the new badge. So you'll see here's my new badge here with a blue Apple icon. And so if you want to create one of those, I'll link that shortcut below. Now, the first thing is with iOS 13.6. So I wanted to share a few things about that, because quite a few people are still running this official version. And what most people complain about to me is battery life. But going through all of those different people that commented on battery life on the community poll, I found that actually 70% plus say that it's as good as iOS 13.5.1, or actually as good as any other that they've ever had with iOS 13. So over 70% are saying it's good battery. However, there are quite a few that aren't, and usually the people that are having bad battery life are a little more vocal when it comes to that. But in general, most people say performance is quite good. There are some bugs with iOS 13.6, and I think they'll be addressed with iOS 13.6.1 in the future. I was expecting an update already, because Apple stopped signing iOS 13.5.1, which usually means there's another update imminent, but it seems like we haven't had it yet. So I would expect maybe this week we'll see one. You never know what Apple's going to do, but we should definitely see iOS 14 beta 4 this week. So if you're having issues with iOS 13.6 and can wait, hold out for that update. I think you'll find that it'll probably fix those issues. It will probably be a small security slash bug fix update. And if one comes out, of course, I'll post a video about it. But so far, most people say it's the most stable version of iOS 13.6. Most people are saying everything's nice and fast and fluid, scrolling, opening different apps. Everything else seems to be working as expected on all devices, all old devices as well. Now, with iOS 14 beta 3, well, there's still bugs for that, and we know all about a lot of those bugs. Mostly people are having issues with widgets. So right here, you'll see that my weather widget is working fine. Some people don't have the weather widget, but that usually is on iPad since they sort of removed it. But you'll see it's not updating on my iPhone XR. So you'll see I can go into it. It gives me real-time weather. But I've got a little stack here I created, but for some reason it's not working on the weather widget. Of course, it's a bug, and you want to report that and feedback, and then Apple will take a look at that and hopefully update that with the next beta. I would expect they've probably already fixed it with beta 4, so I look forward to that. Now, as far as bugs I've been experiencing, I've actually had some issues with touch. From time to time, it will lag. I could go into a menu, it will stutter a little bit, or sometimes I'll touch, it doesn't work. I actually see that more on the iPad side, but I've seen that on my iPhone as well. So it could be on any device at this point. I'm not sure what's going on there. And of course, they disabled 3D touch on 3D touch devices. So maybe there's something to do with touch with that. So maybe there's something odd they made a change to in the code, and hopefully they re-enable that with beta 4. Now, other people are saying they're seeing app crashes. I really haven't seen that too much. And other people are saying it's freezing or lagging. I have seen some freezing and lagging on the iPad. So with iPad OS, for example, I've had different issues where it would occasionally freeze. It wouldn't respond right. And then what I'd have to do is actually do a reboot or turn it off and turn it back on. So I've had to do that a couple times with this particular device, and it's been pretty good, but still it can use some work for sure. There's definitely some bugs with iOS 14 beta 3 and iPad OS beta 3 or iPad OS 4. 14 beta 3. Now, the majority of issues I've had with iOS 14 beta 3 really have to do more with the touch sensitivity, it just not being responsive, and also battery. A battery life for me, well, battery life on iOS 13.6, most people are saying is good, like I said, but on 14, it's not so great. So my battery health on this device is 96%, and that's normal for the age of the device. And so it's not something that really concerns me. So if you're concerned about it dropping, it's just normal. 80% after 2 years is normal. It's not the update doing it. It's just the physical capability of the battery or the lithium ion battery degrading over time. So it's just what happens with batteries. Now you'll see if we take a look at yesterday, I had 3 hours and 5 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 15 minutes of screen off time. Playing music or whatever I was doing with that. I used 50% of my battery without charging, and that's not great. Normally 10 to 12 hours is what I say is good. And again, Apple doesn't really focus on battery early on. They focus on getting the features right, getting things working, and then they can optimize those so that the battery becomes better over time. And so you'll see 3 hours and 5 minutes is pretty terrible. 6 to 7 hours is really what I'm getting with this beta. And that's not too big of an issue, as I can charge it pretty readily or pretty easily, either in my car or at home or in my office. So it's not that big of a deal. But for those of you that really need that battery life, again, don't upgrade to this until you know that you can get sufficient battery life, or maybe you have a charger with you or a battery case. Now, performance has actually been pretty excellent. In fact, most people say performance is quite good. Geekbench scores are showing that it's good. And even on older devices like this iPhone SE, you'll see things open fast. Apps respond quickly. There's no issue there. We'll go in to listen now, wait for it to load, and then we can just scroll. Now, you'll see a little bit of stutter as it loads. That's pretty typical. And you'll see it's a little bit unresponsive, and there's that touch responsiveness I'm seeing. So depending on the device you're on, it's going to give you a few lags or freezes, but in general, performance is good when it's not doing that. So you'll see if I open the camera, it's pretty quick. We can snap a photo quick, and it seems to work okay. So no issues there for me with performance. Most people are saying it's great on older devices, including the iPhone 7, 8, 10, any of those. Now, as far as what you had to say, well, I wanted to look at the YouTube community poll. Now, it's the same poll I used before, so let's go into that. Now, you'll see I have the poll here for beta 3 and also iOS 13.6. On iOS 13.6, there's 15,000 votes, and 46% of you are saying it's great, and only, well, 10% of you are saying it's terrible or has bugs. Now, 28% of you are saying you're using a different version, and 16% are using Android. If we take a look at iOS 14 beta 3, 18,000 people voted. So again, thank you if you're voting on these polls. It's really helpful to not only myself, but helping you out figure out whether or not you should install this beta. But 20% are saying it's great, 3% are saying it's terrible, and 18% are having bugs. That's pretty expected. And I wanted to talk about these polls for just a moment. Some people say I should change what they say. Now, when I say I'm using iOS 13.6 or older, that's pretty obvious, but okay, but some bugs, that just means everything as far as bugs. It's either great, it's not great, it's almost unusable, or it has some bugs. And then Android, because I have another option, and other people are actually viewing this that have Android. And so tell me what you think these should be in the comments below. Now let's take a look at some of the comments, because there's 515 comments at this point. We'll take a look at some of the new ones. Daniel says, it has been working pretty well, except after I'm doing the sleep tracker in the morning, something is wrong with Do Not Disturb. After my phone is normal with Do Not Disturb off and bedtime off, my phone doesn't receive calls. It's taking the call to voicemail. I have to restart my phone to receive calls. And that could definitely be an issue. And this is why I say it's not always a great idea to run a beta on your device if you really depend on it. Caleb says iPhone 11, and I just don't like how the widgets aren't interactive. And one quick note about those widgets. The widgets on iOS 14 update not in real time, but what the developer sets them as. So this weather widget could update every 30 seconds, every 30 minutes if they want it to. It's up to the developer. Hopefully they'll be interactive in the future. Soen says, I have two major problems. 3D touch, control center won't open sometimes, need respring, iPhone 7 Plus. And if I mispronounce your name, I apologize, but Blaze Dahl says 13.6 iPhone 10, running great, good battery life and performance, best version of iOS 13. Uday says, I'm using an iPhone XR, the clock widget not working properly, other third-party app also sometimes crashes. Raphael says, I have it on my iPhone XS Max, still have some bugs in Notes and weather widget also in some apps like Pokemon Go and my bank app. And I'm hearing that a lot. Some games aren't working and banking apps aren't working. So if that's important, again, just stay on the public version if you're having those issues. Harshdeep says, battery was amazing on beta 2, easily pushing 12 hours of screen on time. iPad 6th gen, beta 3 messed everything up, bad battery, stuttering all over the place, random reboots, etc. Hopefully beta 4 is out soon. I am seeing a lot of people say overheating. So Jay Funnett, overheating and bad battery, iPhone 11 Pro Max, and a lot of people are saying that. So some people are saying it's getting warm just doing random tasks or when it wouldn't normally get warm before. It's Speedy says, I use iPhone 7 and live in the UK. I've been checking for iOS 14 beta every day and it does not appear. You have to have the beta profile installed and you have to be either a developer or a public beta tester. Federico says, really great on my iPhone 7, 128 silver, but CPU and GPU are so slow than before. Ranjit says, working fine on my XS with minor bugs. The option to remove a widget from the stack seems to be missing. You can only edit it. Clock timings are not synced. New starter shortcuts added. It definitely is more fluid and faster. Music widget doesn't refresh recently played, and you can't interact like pause or shuffle, etc. So that's disappointing. I hope we see that in the future. It would be much better to be able to interact with those. And then finally, Ali says, bugs, clock widget is not synced with actual time. Some widgets is not working properly in widget center. Performance like scrolling and typing still needs much work. Battery performance is not acceptable. And note, the last two points are not priority for early betas, like I've stated before. Now, as far as iOS 14 beta 4, well, I would expect it probably on Tuesday at this point, although Apple can vary that from day to day, sometimes Monday, sometimes Wednesday, but Tuesday is usually the most likely. And we should see a beta bi-weekly, maybe up until this point, and then hopefully Apple switches to a weekly beta where we'll see it every Tuesday or so, give or take a day. So hopefully we'll see that, and hopefully we'll see iOS 13.6.1 or something along those lines to fix any issues we have with iOS 13.6. So it's a fairly stable version, but it could use a few additional features to make it just that much more stable. So it's okay. It definitely feels old if you're using iOS 14, but hopefully we see that new version soon. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on both of these wallpapers, I couldn't decide which one I wanted to use. So on the iOS 13.6, I used this one. And on iOS 14 beta 3, I used the one in my right hand. So I'll link both in the description below. And of course, if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.